Global Education Media presents Education Report on TV, the television program that promotes educational events and activities across the country for parents, students, practitioners in educational fields across categories, corporate organizations, with products and services that appeal to the youths, government officials, particularly those saddled with the responsibility of managing education, and the general public. It also covers programs and activities in the educational sector, such as awards and opening ceremonies, school inter-house sports, collaborative engagement with NGOs, as well as corporate organizations, plus vocational and technical education, institution for people with special education needs, individual contribution towards the growth and development of education while celebrating success in the educational sector at all levels. For sponsorship and advert placement, please contact 0803-323-2771 or 0812-120-1359. Education Report on TV, promoting excellence in education on television nationwide.
Introduced in the year 2009, the Lagos Eko Secondary Education Project, a partnership program between the Lagos State Government and the World Bank, has indeed contributed immensely towards the development and enhancement of students' learning outcomes with the aim of improving the overall quality of education in all the 667 public junior and senior secondary schools in Lagos State. Through the dynamic leadership of the project coordinator, who is also the special advisor to the Lagos State Governor on Eko Project, Ms. Ronke Aziz, the project supports over 500,000 public school students, more than 8,000 teachers and school administrators, as well as strengthening the capacity of the 6 education districts, consequently contributing to the human capital development. For the special advisor to the Lagos State Governor on Eko Project, Ms. Ronke Aziz, the key drivers of change in revitalizing these schools include direct disbursement of grants to schools, standardized students' assessment, continuous teachers' professional development, support to education districts, public-private collaboration for technical colleges, Governor's Education Award, and the Volunteer Teacher Scheme, to mention but a few. Little wonder the Governor of Lagos State, His Excellency Governor Babatunde Rajifasola-san, at the public unveiling of a book titled The Lagos Eko Project, A Legacy of Excellence, gave kudos to the Eko Project team for a job well done. The book launch was organized at Vetland Senior Grammar School at Gege, Lagos, and it had in attendance stakeholders in the education sector of Lagos State. In her welcome address, the principal of Vetland Senior Grammar School, Mrs. Abiodu Ayemrin, spoke on the projects implemented using the Eko Project grants.
In this school, we have a number of projects presented with the Eko Project grants, which I believe represent similar activities in most of the other 42 schools in the state. These projects, among others, include the graphical study, English language program, mathematics studio, computer science laboratories, mechanical and electrical garden, student forest, cleaning day, and of course the standard and laptop conditions.
Thereafter, the special advisor to the Governor on Eko Project, Ms. Ronke Aziz, a woman with great foresight who has worked tirelessly in ensuring that the aims and objectives of the project are achieved, came on board for her presentation.
The World Bank gave us a minimum project indicator to train 5,385 teachers on leadership and other core subjects. Within that 4 years, we trained 16,445 teachers. And with that means we accomplished 305% achievement. The World Bank gave us a target of 1,706 school principals and vice principals to be trained. We achieved in the 4 years 7,998 principals and vice principals trained. And that we accomplished 469%. At the end of Eko Project in 2013, World Bank rated the Lagos Eko Project our own highly satisfactory.
In his keynote address, Governor Babatunde Fashola-san stated that the World Bank loan model for the project has been integrated and will remain firmly applicable in the state.
To see them holding thermometers again, for me, is a return to what it used to be. To see them keeping their own plan of giving peace, it means now that they can do proper laboratory experiments again. And this is what this fund has done. For all of you who have lent a hand to achieve this back for this team, I say thank you. Yes, the World Bank project will end, but the model that made that money work is more important for me than the money. Now that that model has been internalized, I assure you that the idea of direct grants into the classrooms, into the schools, is one that will remain firmly with us in Lagos State. Even after the World Bank project has gone, and even after I stop being your governor, because we have told the Ministry of Economic Planning and Budget that this must now be incorporated into our annual budget system as a given.
High point of the day was the unveiling of the book, The Lagos Eco Project, a legacy of excellence by the governor in company of other dignitaries.
To the glory of God, towards continuing development, excellence, and quality in the Lagos public education system, it is my honor and pleasure to unveil the Lagos Eco Project Legacy of Excellence book, which is a documentation really of all of the projects, the policies and programs that have been undertaken in the schools where the monies were distributed, showing the record of how each school moved slowly, firmly, but surely towards improved qualitative and quantitative learning and very, very progressive outcomes. I sincerely hope that this record will spur all those who come across it that in this land, nothing is impossible. Only us can stop ourselves. And that whenever we set our minds to do something, the God on our side, we will achieve. Thank you and God bless you.
The governor also took time to go on tour of the school's facilities.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. A lonely place to be. And so I learned to depend on me. I decided
also present at the event was the Commissioner for Education in Lagos State and the mother of 10 million children and still counting, Mrs. Olayinka Oladunjoye. She shared her opinion on ECHO project with Education Report on TV.
It's an ECHO project. So we have come to tell the world what the project is all about and how much we have achieved with the money they've given to us. That's what we have done today, both in the junior classes and the senior classes. And to tell the world that we are accountable for all the money. To tell them that our principals are happier now that the money is coming to them directly, because they can now spend the money on what they want to spend it on.
Through hard work, commitment and selflessness, the special advisor to the Lagos State Governor on ECHO project, Ms. Ronke Aziz, has touched the lives of students in public secondary schools across the state, hence leaving our footprints on the sands of time.
What we did is to ensure that the funds were judiciously spent, that our teachers were well trained, that all the resources required for teaching and learning were available inside the schools as much as possible, that, you know, we had people within the community like the SBMCs, our parents, retired teachers, retired TGPSs, everybody being on board to work with us for the greater good of our children.
With the notable achievements recorded by the Lagos ECHO Secondary School project team headed by Ms. Ronke Aziz, the sky is just the beginning for secondary school education in Lagos State.